Haven't gotten mage or rogue in quite some time here. Actually, it's mostly mage I haven't gotten. I've gotten one rogue and zero mages since the expansion. That sucks. Yeah, okay. Wow, these cards are bad. Pyro's okay, it doesn't really have synergy with Whirlwind in my opinion, but I guess the Gurubashi synergy is pretty good. Alright. Card's so bad. Still yet to get a weapon. Oh. Hello there. That helps so much. Come on. Doesn't have bad synergy, it's a fucking weapon. I really need one. This deck is a joke. Okay. This might be one of the worst decks I've ever drafted. I think this arena score is gonna be like 62. Wow, it's 62.0. I've never guessed it dead on before. Yes, this is the worst deck I've ever drafted. I have 129 deck, and this is the worst one. So as far as my own stats, it's in the bottom 0.7% of decks. The worst. Yeah, I've gone 12 wins with like 58 whatever myself, but that was many expansions ago. The tier score overall goes up considerably as more cards are released. Here we go. 60.3, 10-3 druid. Last year though. Trespass. No. That 50-50 would have definitely won the game for me. That's pretty bad.
Maybe... No.
Ah, the 1-1's a real problem, man. What's the draw? It's a lightning bolt. Pretty OP lightning bolt there. Can't really bash and expect to win. Cleanse the sun well. Pretty sure that's the best play. Trading and not trading has the same result. But, it's a little bit less risky if I'm proactive. Well, if I can out top deck him, I'll win. But I don't know how likely that really is. My deck is mostly mid range. And I have to out top deck him right away. Oh, another one. Oh, amazing. He's also just been really lucky with the totems, which has been a pretty big problem this game. This card is worthless. I can maybe do something if I get a really good revenge, but with a heal totem, it's extremely unlikely.
You're in trouble now.
There is no way I can win anymore. Basically, this is Holy Smite, this is Moonfire. I have a Whirlwind, a Holy Smite, and a Moonfire right now. Yeah, that's not bad. Just need to not run up against Taunt Totem. Oh, Fire Elemental Lethal. And Lava Burst. There you go, guys. That's a 12-win Shaman deck. pretty fucked up to queue against that with a 62 warrior.
Fist.
Thanks, guys. Well, even with the worst deck ever, I can generally outplay some opponents. Even on warrior. But, there's not much to outplay when you have, like, top 1% of shamans versus bottom, like, 0.5% of arena. Like, you just, I can't close that gap. That's not how Hearthstone works. Like, the best constructed player in the world is not going to win a game against an actual deck if he has 20 angry chickens in his deck, right? That's just not going to happen. Good boys. Looking very good. Twenty angry chickens and 10 hobgoblins.
Your mother was a murloc.
Not so sure that would actually do well, but that's interesting. Damn. Yeah, this is good at least. If he Kodos, can't hit the Gurubashi, so that's nice. This game's almost impossible for him to win. I got a lead on the board, I countered him. He went second as a warlock. That's GG, boys. Out of what? No, 62 average tier score among all the cards.
I am the dancing master.
Tap it. Oh yeah. It's lethal anyway. Druid finished 8-3. Okay.
Magni versus
going second against Rogue. There goes like half my chance to win. Fine. Just keep some whatever early game cards, hope for the best. Why do you guys think it's such a big deal that I never bothered to learn to drive?
It's getting hot in here. It's getting hot in here.
I need this to hit. Whoa, it actually hit! couldn't imagine life without driving. Just use bicycle. Hmm. If you have to go far, then you get transit or an Uber. I mean, my coworkers, I mean, when I was a computer technician, I was making what, like 20 something thousand a year. They're probably putting like a third of that into their car. I use the bicycle. I got in great shape. So many. I think I lost maybe about 10 minutes to 20 minutes a day extra compared to driving to work and back home. The question is, at that time for me was not why should I drive? Question was, why the fuck were they driving? Right? So, I don't know. I think it's... I'm curious. What's the big deal? If you had a corporate job, you would need a car. In some cases. Don't you slamming your keyboard over? What? So many options. Oh, just upset at something? Are you upset that I don't drive? Rania's really upset, guys. Maybe I'll learn to drive. I'll serve some purpose. How did I get Rampage? I picked Warrior and got really crappy options in my draft. Why is it so bad to go second against Rogue? Because Rogue's a tempo class, and if you go second, you lose a shitload of tempo. Which basically means you don't really win. The best aspect about Rogue is they will out-tempo you. If they go first and you go second, you amplify their advantage. It's a pretty big deal, really. Nope, nope, nope. There you go, that one. Yep, you can hit that one. There you go. Rogue is better with coin. Incorrect. There has never been a class ever in Arena that had an advantage going second. The Hearth Arena stats showed that. I think the exception to that was before the game was released. Before Rogue was nerfed. Pre-launch. I think then Rogue could have had an advantage. By going, second.
So many choices.
The sun well. You have a sick car and stuff. When I was a kid, I had like a bunch of stickers and shit. It came with bubblegum and Romania, like fast cars and stuff. And like I have that admiration towards cool looking cars, but the cars I like are generally considered shitty and ugly. My favorite cars are 80s and 90s German luxury cars. Oh, damn, dude. 80s Audi sedan. Shit looks sick. Late 80s Mercedes. Sweet, sweet car. I'll show you guys what I'm talking about here. Look at that. Look at that, boys. That is a sick looking car. Isn't it? Yeah, I fucking want it. But you're gonna have to drive. Yeah, I also love ABBA. ABBA's one of the best bands. So yeah, those are the cars I like. I have some admiration towards cars and all that. I used to watch, like... what is it, like... Jack My Pimp My Ride, I think? And overhauled, and like Jesse James and his three friends built some stupid car on the Discovery Channel. I watched those shows when I was a kid, but I don't feel the need to buy an expensive sports car and learn to drive. I think it's pointless and wasteful. Jack My Ride. Oh yeah, that show. Volvo P1800 is the best looking car. Let me check this out here. That is a pretty sweet looking car. People who criticize you for not driving don't live in Ontario. I did the math. The adjusted speed of driving, factoring the time spent work, means biking to work is faster. They want $250 a month for insurance for me because I'm a young male driver. $250 a month's pretty good, isn't it? Car insurance. $250 a month, you got lucky, bro. Yeah. Yeah, in Toronto, $250 a month for car insurance is pretty low. So again, you know, I was working, I was making a bit over $20,000 a year as a computer technician. All of my coworkers had cars. What a fucking waste, right? How can you justify that? Average car insurance, Toronto. Ready to ride. Oh, shit.
It's hammer time. Trespasser.
Apparently, the average cost to insure a car is only like $1,500 a year in Toronto. That seems pretty low. I think that's close to what my dad pays. Yeah, 20 years, zero accidents. And his car is kind of a piece of crap. Yeah, so piece of crap car, 20 years driving experience with zero accidents, and he pays, I think, about $1,000, maybe a little bit extra in car insurance. What's that? Yeah. Nah, I don't know if I should take the 4 damage. I'm just gonna kill this for free. It's gonna kill it for free anyway, then I'm gonna kill that for free anyway. So I think I'll just leave it. My dad has 20 years driving experience. In Canada.
Silvermoon shall not fall.
Today, I don't have to be a princess.
You'd pay $2,000 a year for car insurance if all my medical was free. Right, but it's not.
You must cleanse the sun well.
Like, in every country, there's some industry that just scams the crap out of its citizens. In Canada, we have insurance companies and telecommunications. Damn, what a ridiculous topic that is. Real estate is generally kind of a scam everywhere. That's a tough one. That was the first topic I bitched about. The topic quick shot when you need damage when you have no hand is pretty fucking insane. I'm 3-1 with the worst deck ever, right? I mean, that's pretty good. That's pretty good, guys. It's easy to get him to Canada, just say you're from China or Syria. Yeah, I'm Chinese. It's actually not that easy to get to Canada. Okay. It's a pretty good opener. It's going to be a lot harder to get into Canada. I think in a few years there's going to be a presidential candidate called Crump. He's going to build a wall to keep the Americans out. It's going to make him pay for it too. I think it's a pretty good idea. Those guys come over here for free healthcare. Ridiculous.
You regret this.
Okay. Oh, that's a very good draw. Yeah, internet's pretty terrible in Canada. And it costs you a shitload to have it. Made a spreadsheet to compare driving speed to biking speed. Please don't hellfire me. Please don't hellfire me. Don't hellfire me, bro. I have the worst warrior deck I've ever had. I have the worst deck I've ever had. Kill the imp.
Yes!
Kill them all!
Oh, man!
Finish him!
This is awesome. You can get decent internet in some parts. It's very difficult. Like, you know, I told you guys in Canada you can get bullshit internet and it costs you like $200 a month. And some people said I was lying about that. Well, I wasn't really.
Push forward. Battle commencing.
It's just that I probably should have played Rampage, huh? It's just that you can get good internet. You just have to live in the business area of downtown across the street from the largest bank in Canada's headquarters building. If you live there, you can get amazing internet. If you live anywhere else in Toronto, you're fucked. But If you go to like the website of these internet companies, they list those plans. They're like, we offer this plan. It's like, but no, they don't. They don't. No, you have to live in like five different buildings downtown to get that plan. Or in like new development in like, you know, another building up north or something. It's ridiculous. I would say 95% of areas in Toronto has old infrastructure and you can only get very basic internet plans compared to what you see on the websites that offer them. When I stayed with my dad, I could get the second worst plan, and for my upload, they only delivered a quarter of the speed that they advertised. A quarter. So I had a quarter of the second worst plan offered by my internet company. Also, I was bandwidth capped, and I couldn't upload while I was streaming, so I had to get two lines, and I had to make one of them unlimited. At the end of the day, my internet bill every month was like $230 for the first few years that I did streaming. Worth. Not quite. Canadian dollar, lol. I think at that time Canadian dollar was higher than the US dollar. But yeah, it's pretty bad right now. Which is good because I make more money as a result.
Cleanse the sun well.
Okay. Vegan economics. Why not Deathbite? Ah, you get a free kill. It's not as likely as you think to get one damage. Unless you're this guy and you have a bunch of ghouls, I guess. Then it's pretty easy to get one damage. Very nice. Get to keep the doggy. I don't think I can win this game though. Warrior versus warrior is largely minion battles in the late game, and I don't have much of those. So. Yeah, like that's kind of like the end there. If he didn't have the ghoul against my Shattered Sun play, I think I would have won. But he had two ghouls, which fucked me over in the early game. Now I lose. Probably have to get a Force Tank Max to do anything. No, I can't do anything. This guy's a really good warrior deck. I'm thinking if I should concede right now. Let's do one more turn, I guess. Yeah, it's really good deck versus really bad deck. It sucks he had the answers. If he had no answers early on, I think I would have won, just because my opener was pretty good. But he had every answer he needed. It's a sick looking Audi.
Magni versus Jaina.
You asked for it.
For Cosmodan.
250 is rather low. Also, the guy says his auto insurance is high. Needs to be hit in the head with a bag of carrots. No shit, auto insurance is high for a young male. My brain hurts, Kripp. Okay. Oh, going second again. No. Well, it's probably going to be the end of this arena run, but four wins with the worst deck I've ever drafted. That's not bad. Have I ever been to Greece? I have indeed. I stayed there for like a year and a half.
I'll show them. I'll show them all.
Damn, dude, that's pretty fucked up. So if you make $24 an hour after tax, and it's 15 minutes driving versus 40 minutes cycling, it's better to cycle. $24 after tax is actually pretty damn good. Because the tax rate, even the bottom one, is like fucking like 27% or something. So what is that? 24 divided by 1.27. Am I dumb? Yeah, I'm dumb. One second. I guess I'm fucked then. Be times, yeah. That's like $30 and like 50 cents an hour. That's a pretty well paid job. So in a well paid job in Canada, biking 40 minutes is better than driving 15 minutes. That honestly includes almost everybody. That's very interesting. The bottom federal tax rate is 19%, the top is 29%. Yes, but the tax rate that you're referring to does not include the provincial tax, which is another 20%.
Take this blade.
Yeah, this guy's deck's just insane minions. I can't do this. It's even worse if you have an expensive car. I don't think anyone's making $50 a day in Canada. Minimum wage in Canada is about $11. I actually don't know what it is, but it used to be $10.25 when I was working.
Put this apple on your head.
It's $10.50 right now. Nobody's getting paid $50 a day unless they're working part-time. And if they are, then yeah, okay. So 11:25 in Ontario. Oh, I searched by Canada. Let me check. Ontario minimum wage. Oh yeah, 11:25. So yeah, nobody's making $50 a day. Say $7. Well, if you adjust for the difference in currencies, it's not much less, but I think living expenses in Canada are generally lower. Oh, great, Malagos. Nice. This guy's deck seems really fucking insane. What the fuck? See, this is the shit I hate, dude. You have a deck that on a good on a good day goes 12-0 versus the worst deck I've ever played. I'm so sad I can't punish that right now. Okay. Top deck polymorph. One off lethal. I think it's bullshit that I have to play people like that at 4-2. I think it's bullshit that you have to play people like that at all. Okay, well, worst deck ever, over at least. I got legendary out of it. Nat the Dark, for sure. Nothing new, I guess. Oh, four wins is very good for that deck. I think most people would average zero with that deck, so. Pretty good, I guess, but still. It's so frustrating. I talk about it in tomorrow's video. Hearthstone, out of all the card games I've played recently, has the worst deck equality in Arena. Like, Chronicle RuneScape's Dungeoneering mode, everybody gets the same rarities of cards. In Faria, the card's rarity actually represents how good it is most of the time. Neither of those things are true for Hearthstone. You literally have matchups where one player has 0% chance to win. Fucking ridiculous. Sucks to get caught up on the receiving end of that. Alright, now I'm gonna do a few more arenas before we do some constructed. Dude, this is bullshit. I haven't had mage in forever. One, okay. This one is one. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13 arenas without mage. I'm busting out the fucking calculator, guys. Smiling, freaking, man. that right? That can't be right. It's 1 in 3. You lose a 1 in 3 13 times in a row. I just got a million, 1 in a million. It can't be that low, I must have fucked up. It's not 1 in 3? Yeah, it is. It's 1 in 3 chance to get mage when you drift. Haven't gotten mage or rogue in quite some time here. Actually, it's mostly mage I haven't gotten. I've gotten 1 rogue and 0 mages since the expansion. That sucks. Yeah, okay. Wow, these cards are bad. Is okay. It doesn't really have synergy with Whirlwind in my opinion, but I guess the Gurubashi synergy is pretty good. Alright. Cards so bad. Still yet to get a weapon. Oh. Hello there. That helps so much. Come on. Doesn't have bad synergy, it's a fucking weapon. I really need one. This deck is a joke. Okay. This might be one of the worst decks I've ever drafted. I think this arena score is gonna be like 62. Wow, it's 62.0. I've never guessed it dead on before. Yes, this is the worst deck I've ever drafted. I have 129 deck, and this is the worst one. So as far as my own stats, it's in the bottom 0.7% of decks. The worst. Yeah, I've gone 12 wins with like 58 whatever myself, but that was many expansions ago. The tier score overall goes up considerably as more cards are released. Here we go. 60.3, 10 and 3 druid. Last year, though. Okay. No. That 50-50 would have definitely won the game for me. That's pretty bad.
Maybe... No, no, no.
Ah, the 1-1's a real problem, man. What's the draw? It's a lightning bolt. Pretty OP lightning bolt there. Can't really bash and expect to win.
Cleanse the sun well.
Pretty sure that's the best play. Trading and not trading has the same result. But, it's a little bit less risky if I'm proactive. Well, if I can out top deck him, I'll win. But I don't know how likely that really is. My deck is mostly mid range. And I have to out top deck him right away. Oh, another one. Oh, amazing. He's also just been really lucky with the totems, which has been a pretty big problem this game. This card is worthless. I can maybe do something if I get a really good revenge, but with a heal totem, it's extremely unlikely.
You're in trouble now.
There is no way I can win anymore. Basically, this is Holy Smite, this is Moonfire. I have a Whirlwind, a Holy Smite, and a Moonfire right now. Yeah, that's not bad. Just need to not run up against Taunt Totem. Oh, Fire Elemental lethal. And Lava Burst. There you go, guys. That's a 12-win Shaman deck. pretty fucked up to queue against that with a 62 warrior. Thanks, guys. Well, even with the worst deck ever, I can generally outplay some opponents. Even on warrior. But, there's not much to outplay when you have, like, top 1% of shamans versus bottom, like, 0.5% of arena. Like, you just, I can't close that gap. That's not how Hearthstone works. Like, the best constructed player in the world is not going to win a game against an actual deck if he has 20 angry chickens in his deck, right? That's just not going to happen. Good boys. Looking very good. Twenty angry chickens and 10 hobgoblins.
Your mother was a Merlock.
Not so sure that would actually do well, but that's interesting. Damn. Yeah, this is good at least. If he Kodos, can't hit the Gurubashi, so that's nice. This game's almost impossible for him to win. I got a lead on the board, I countered him. He went second as a Warlock. That's GG, boys. Out of what? No, 62 average tier score among all the cards.
I am the dancing master.
Tap it. Oh yeah. It's lethal anyway. Druid finished 8-3. Okay.
Magni versus
going second against Rogue. There goes like half my chance to win. Fine. Just keep some whatever early game cards, hope for the best. Why do you guys think it's such a big deal that I never bothered to learn to drive?
It's getting hot in here. It's getting hot in here.
I need this to hit. Whoa, it actually hit! couldn't imagine life without driving. Just use bicycle. Hmm. If you have to go far, then you get transit or an Uber. I mean, my coworkers, I mean, when I was a computer technician, I was making what, like 20 something thousand a year. They're probably putting like a third of that into their car. I use the bicycle. I got in great shape. So many. I think I lost maybe about 10 minutes to 20 minutes a day extra compared to driving to work and back home. Question is, at that time for me was not why should I drive. Question was, why the fuck were they driving, right? So I don't know. I think it's, I'm curious. What's the big deal? Apparently the average cost to insure a car is only like $1,500 a year in Toronto. That seems pretty low. I think that's close to what my dad pays. Yeah. 20 years, zero accidents. And his car is kind of a piece of crap. Yeah, so piece of crap car, 20 years driving experience with zero accidents, and he pays, I think, about $1,000, maybe a little bit extra in car insurance. What's that? Yeah. Nah, I don't know if I should take the 4 damage. I'm just gonna kill this for free. It's gonna kill it for free anyway, then I'm gonna kill that for free anyway. So I think I'll just leave it. My dad has 20 years driving experience. In Canada.
Silvermoon shall not fall.
Today, I don't have to be a princess.
You'd pay $2,000 a year for car insurance if all my medical was free. Right, but it's not.
You must cleanse the sun well.
Like, in every country, there's some industry that just scams the crap out of its citizens. In Canada, we have insurance companies and telecommunications. Damn, what a ridiculous topic that is. Real estate is generally kind of a scam everywhere. That's a tough one. That was the first top deck I bitched about. The top deck quick shot when you need damage when you have no hand is pretty fucking insane. I'm 3-1 with the worst deck ever, right? I mean, that's pretty good. That's pretty good, guys. It's easy to get into Canada, just say you're from China or Syria. Yeah, I'm Chinese. It's actually not that easy to get into Canada. Okay. It's a pretty good opener. It's going to be a lot harder to get into Canada. I think in a few years there's going to be a presidential candidate called Crump. He's going to build a wall to keep the Americans out. It's going to make him pay for it too. I think it's a pretty good idea. Those guys come over here for free healthcare. Ridiculous. Oh, that's a very good draw. Yeah, internet's pretty terrible in Canada. And it costs you a shitload to have it. A spreadsheet to compare driving speed to biking speed.
Do I have to?
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
Please don't hellfire me. Please don't hellfire me. Don't hellfire me, bro. I have the worst warrior deck I've ever had. I have the worst deck I've ever had. Kill the imp.
Yes!
Kill them all!
Oh, man.
Finish him.
This is awesome. You can get decent internet in some parts. It's very difficult. Like, you know, I told you guys in Canada you can get bullshit internet and it costs you like $200 a month. And some people said I was lying about that. Well, I wasn't really.
Push forward. Battle commencing.
It's just that I probably should have played Rampage, huh? It's just that you can get good internet. You just have to live in the business area of downtown across the street from the largest bank in Canada's headquarters building. If you live there, you can get amazing internet. If you live anywhere else in Toronto, you're fucked. But if you go to... if you go to, like, the website of these internet companies, they list those plans. They're like, we offer this plan. It's like, but no, they don't. They don't. No, you have to live in, like, 5 different buildings downtown to get that plan. Or in, like, new development in, like... you know. If you had a corporate job, you would need a car. In some cases. Why aren't you slamming your keyboard over? What? Oh, just upset at something? Are you upset that I don't drive? Rania's really upset, guys. Maybe I'll learn to drive. I'll serve some purpose. How did I get Rampage? I picked Warrior and got really crappy options in my draft. Why is it so bad to go second against Rogue? Because Rogue's a tempo class, and if you go second, you lose a shitload of tempo. Which basically means you don't really win. The best aspect about Rogue is they will out-tempo you. If they go first and you go second, you amplify their advantage. It's a pretty big deal, really. Nope, nope, nope. There you go, that one. Yep, you can hit that one. There you go. Rogue is better with coin. Incorrect. There has never been a class ever in Arena that had an advantage going second. The Hearth Arena stats showed that. I think the exception to that was before the game was released. Before Rogue was nerfed. Pre-launch. I think then Rogue could have had an advantage. By going, second.
So many choices.
You have a sick car and stuff. When I was a kid, I had like a bunch of stickers and shit. It came with bubblegum and Romania. Like fast cars and stuff, and like I have that admiration towards cool looking cars, but the cars I like are generally considered shitty and ugly. My favorite cars are 80s and 90s German luxury cars. Oh damn, dude, 80s Audi sedan, shit looks sick. Late 80s Mercedes, sweet sweet car. I'll show you guys what I'm talking about here. Look at that. Look at that, boys. That is a sick looking car. Isn't it? Yeah, I fucking want it. But you're gonna have to drive. Yeah, I also love ABBA. ABBA's one of the best bands. So yeah, those are the cars I like. I have some admiration towards cars and all that. I used to watch, like, what is it, like, Jack My Pimp My Ride, I think? And Overhauled. And, like, Jesse James and his three friends built some stupid car on the Discovery Channel. I watched those shows when I was a kid, but I don't feel the need to buy an expensive sports car and learn to drive. I think it's pointless and wasteful.
Hurry up. Push online.
Jack My Ride. Oh yeah, that show. Volvo P1800 is the best looking car. Let me check this out here. That is a pretty sweet looking car. Criticize you for not driving. Don't live in Ontario. I did the math. The adjusted speed of driving, factoring the time spent work, means biking to work is faster. They want $250 a month for insurance for me because I'm a young male driver. $250 a month's pretty good, isn't it? Car insurance. $250 a month. You got lucky, bro. Yeah. Yeah, in Toronto, $250 a month for car insurance is pretty low. So again, you know, I was working, I was making a bit over $20,000 a year as a computer technician. All of my coworkers had cars. What a fucking waste, right? How can you justify that? Average car insurance, Toronto. Ready to ride. You know, another building up north or something. It's ridiculous. I would say 95% of areas in Toronto has old infrastructure, and you can only get very basic internet plans compared to what you see on the websites that offer them. When I stayed with my dad, I could get the second worst plan, and for my upload, they only delivered a quarter of the speed that they advertised. A quarter. So I had a quarter of the second worst plan offered by my internet company. Also, I was banned with capped, and I couldn't upload while I was streaming, so I had to get two lines. And I had to make one of them unlimited. At the end of the day, my internet bill every month was like $230 for the first few years that I did streaming. Worth. Not quite. Canadian dollar, lol. I think at that time Canadian dollar was higher than the US dollar. But yeah, it's pretty bad right now. Which is good because I make more money as a result. vegan economics. Why not Deathbite? Ah, you get a free kill. It's not as likely as you think to get one damage. Unless you're this guy and you have a bunch of ghouls, I guess. Then it's pretty easy to get one damage. Very nice. Get to keep the doggy. I don't think I can win this game though. Warrior versus warrior is largely minion battles in the late game, and I don't have much of those. So. Yeah, like that's kind of like the end there. If he didn't have the ghoul against my Shattered Sun play, I think I would have won. But he had two ghouls, which fucked me over in the early game. Now I lose. Probably have to get a Force Tank max to do anything. No, I can't do anything. This guy's a really good warrior deck. I'm thinking if I should concede right now. Let's do one more turn, I guess. Yeah, it's really good deck versus really bad deck. It sucks he had the answers. If he had no answers early on, I think I would have won, just because my opener was pretty good. But he had every answer he needed. It's a sick looking Audi. $250 is rather low. Also, the guy says his auto insurance is high. Needs to be hit in the head with a bag of carrots. No shit, auto insurance is high for a young male. My brain hurts, Kripp. Okay. Oh, going second again. No. Well, it's probably going to be the end of this arena run, but four wins with the worst deck I've ever drafted. That's not bad. Have I ever been to Greece? I have indeed. I stayed there for like a year and a half.
I'll show them. I'll show them all.
Damn, dude, that's pretty fucked up. So if you make $24 an hour after tax, and it's 15 minutes driving versus 40 minutes cycling, it's better to cycle. $24 after tax is actually pretty damn good. Because the tax rate, even the bottom one, is like fucking like 27% or something. So what is that? 24 divided by 1.27. Am I dumb?